Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it's all about resetting your Todoist. Now, sometimes we end up filling our Todoist with hundreds, if not thousands of tasks, and we just get so overwhelmed, we decide, that's it, I'm going to get rid of everything and start again. Now, there isn't actually a reset button in Todoist, but there are three ways that you can reset your Todoist. Two of which are what I would describe as hard Todoist bankruptcies, one of which is a soft Todoist bankruptcy. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this episode, then please help me by clicking on that like button down there. Yep, that like button just down there. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into Todoist now, and I'm going to show you the three ways that you can declare Todoist bankruptcy. Okay, first up, let's clear something up. Todoist does not have a general reset button. What you can do is, if you go into your settings here, you can go down to the bottom here, you can delete your Todoist account, but that just means that you have deleted the whole account and you would have to restart a new account. Now, that is one way to do a Todoist reset. You can create a new account, delete your old account, and create a new account. Now, remember, when you do delete an account, it is permanent. You're not going to be able to restore anything. So there are a couple of other ways that you can do this. Again, there's some ways that can be considered, what I would consider permanent, and there are ways which are semi-permanent where you can get things back. So the easiest way to do this, if you really want to do a complete reset of your Todoist, is you go through each individual project and you have a choice. Now, this is where we get hard bankruptcy. So you can call it a hard Todoist bankruptcy. That means you're deleting everything permanently. Then you delete the project. Archive the project and you can get it back. And I'll show you how to do that in a moment. So let's just hit archive on that one. This week, we'll hit archive on this one. So we're just going to go through these and we're going to archive these projects so that I can actually restore them after I've shown you how to do this. So you just click the three buttons to the right, to the right of the project in this sidebar, hit archive project, hit archive project, hit archive project. I don't want to delete these. Then we've got here. So let's just say this week's boards. I can go in there and say, delete this one. So this is the hard reset. Delete the project. Now you're going to get the option to, are you absolutely sure you want to do this? Let's delete it. That's gone forever. You're never going to get it back. Same here. Let's delete this project permanently. Delete. It's gone. And content schedule. Let's delete that project. And it's gone. So now what you've done is you've actually cleared up your projects. Now you'd have to do the same with your labels as well. So you go into the three dots here and you can delete the label like this. Just delete the label. Again, you're doing this manually, but as you can see, it doesn't actually take that long to do. And it also is a way that you're kind of reviewing things as you're doing this. So you can just go in there, delete the label. These are permanent. Every time you delete something like this, it is permanent. You're deleting the labels. You can also go into your filters, and I'm not just going to do that. You get the idea. You can go into filters, I can click on there, I can delete the filter. So you can do the same thing, and you can remove these by just clicking on the three dots there and remove from favorites. Again, click on the three dots to the right of it, remove from favorites. So essentially what you've done now is you've cleared up your Todoist. It's all clear. Now, as I mentioned, if you delete your projects, they're gone for good. You're not going to be able to get them back. And of course, if you close down your account, you remove your account permanently, of course, it's gone again. So if you do what I showed you before, which is you archive the project. So let's say I've archived those projects. So it takes a few minutes to come back. I can actually bring these back. So I can go to the three dots here and unarchive. I can go into my
this week. Let's go into there. I can unarchive that. Unarchive that. I've got two this week's. I've archived two this week's. Unarchive. Let's do this. Long term on hold. Unarchive. And then I can actually put this back into, where's my this week? There we go. I'll unarchive that. So I can now actually put these back in their right order. I can drag this one back up to the top here. I can move that one down to the bottom. I can bring, there we go. We got it all back in order. Now, the thing is, when you do restore the archives, you can actually, your tasks are back. They're still here. So you haven't lost the actual projects. You can bring them back at any time, and you don't need to worry too much about space, because it would take forever, if you like, to actually use up your archive space, and Todoist would give you a warning if you're getting close. I have no idea, by the way, how much space you do get, so that's something just to keep in mind. But there you go, there's two ways, or three ways, of actually resetting your account. So the first one is just to delete the account and restart again with a new account. That's permanent. The second way is to go into the three dots at the side, the ellipses at the right-hand side of the project in the project sidebar. Click on the three dots and you can delete the project. Now, when you delete the project, remember it is permanent. You're not ever going to be able to get it back. The second way is what I would call the soft reset, or the soft bankruptcy, if you like. That's archive the project. Now, when you archive the project, you can restore it from the archived projects down here. You can get them back. So there you go, a quick episode this week. I've seen a lot of people asking, how do you reset Todoist? How do you do declare bankruptcy in Todoist and bring it all back? Well, that is the way. There's no reset button, but you can do it using the delete function, the archive function, or just completely erase your account and start again. So there you go. That's all you need to know about resetting your Todoist. Thank you so much for watching this episode, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.
Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now, I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently, I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system, that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done, so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.